I have no idea on how long it would take. The SGX licensing arrangement that we have has a notice period of 6 months. So that is when the SGX Nifty license will terminate, which is in August. People can trade India even today if they want to onshore. And obviously Gift City is an operating exchange. If they want to trade a Nifty contract on Gift City, that is also offered and available. So I think there are alternatives available for people. We are in discussions with investors to try and make sure that the transition is orderly and it's not disruptive for anyone. And so from that perspective, all the exchanges will do whatever they can to facilitate an orderly transition.
Also, sir, did you see any impact on the Indian markets, considering that there was some increase in the F&O trade? Has there been an impact that has been seen so far now that the SGX Nifty licensing may get cancelled by August?
No, not really. At this point in time, there isn't any kind of material increase in volume in the Indian exchanges that you can attribute to this particular development.
What are your expectations? By how much do you see this volume going up by, considering that we have in fact taken a move like this?
It's very hard to tell. I mean, I can't comment on how much volumes would increase in India and what kind of liquidity would flow back, etc. I can't give you a number on that. But the expectation is that some liquidity would move back to India. Some liquidity might move to Gift City. Some liquidity might just disappear, because there are some people who have been trading in other jurisdictions who may choose not to trade in India. So it could be a combination of all that. It's very hard for me to give you a number.
Also, sir, one last question. This was more of a hedging for a lot of investors, a way of hedging for a lot of investors. Now, although they may have to move to Gift City, where they can still trade in dollar denominations, but how do you see the impact on those investors, and what do you see can happen there, you know, to kind of assuage their concerns?
Like I said, there is a hedging mechanism that's available. Certainly, the SGX Nifty will continue for 6 months. So it's not that people are not going to be able to trade the Nifty futures in Singapore for 6 months. So within that time frame, there are alternative hedging mechanisms that are available. You can hedge in India as well. There is an onshore Nifty contract available that is very liquid. And there is a Nifty futures contract available in Gift as well. So investors can hedge their India positions through alternatives.
Would you be able to tell us what kind of products that may come out of the Nifty family at SGX Nifty?
No. SGX Nifty will get terminated in August, right?
Absolutely. So they are planning to launch some products.
So I have no. So that I can't comment on. That is SGX's plan, and I have no idea what an alternative product would be. All I can say is that any kind of alternative product to trade based on Indian securities will require prices from Indian exchanges.
Yes.
And that we have said in our press release quite clearly, that prices cannot be the end. There is an end use restriction on data, where data cannot be used for trading an offshore derivatives contract. So any kind of product that gets developed on an Indian security will require data from Indian exchanges. And so I'm not sure what that product would be.